Hotel Infinity, Part 1. This is a riddle about the nature of infinity. The riddle goes like this. Suppose that you are the proprietor of a hotel, and that your hotel happens to be a very special hotel because it has an infinite number of rooms. What do we mean by infinite number of rooms? That is an excellent question. What I mean in this case is this. All the rooms in your hotel lie on the same side of a single extremely long hallway. When you first enter the hallway from the lobby, you see room 1, it's the first door on your left. The second door on your left is room 2, the third is room 3, and so on. And it keeps going forever. The 1,000th door on your left is room 1,000. The 1,000,000th door on your left is room 1,000,000. For every positive integer, there's a room labeled by that number, and the rooms are arranged in order in this endless hallway. Now, you might be thinking of some objections to this scenario, and if so, you're right. There are a lot of reasons why this hotel can't actually exist in the real world. For one thing, if we assume the rooms are all the same size and the walls are all the same thickness and made of brick, then the construction of this hotel would require an infinite number of bricks. It would have to be built on an infinitely large planet or space station. It would require an infinite area of carpet. It'd need an infinite number of beds and mini refrigerators and such. And even assuming you could gather infinite quantities of all these supplies, it would take an arbitrarily long amount of time for your guests to walk to their rooms. For example, a guest who'd reserved room at Google would never be able to walk that length of hallway in their lifetime. And since even electricity travels at a finite speed, if you tried to forward a call from the lobby to riddle Google, it would take a very, very long time for the message to arrive. In short, there are many, many reasons why this hotel couldn't exist in the real world. But fortunately, we're not talking about the real world. We're talking about math. And when we do math, we can make up whatever rules we want just to see what happens. So for the purposes of this riddle, suppose this hotel of yours exists in a universe in which it's possible to gather an infinite number of bricks and such. Suppose also that your hotel is equipped with a teleporter that allows your guests to reach their assigned rooms instantaneously, so they don't have to spend their whole lives trekking down that hallway. And suppose also that you, in your office, have access to an intercom that allows you to make announcements to every room at once, and in this universe, electricity travels instantaneously, so your voice will really play in every room at the same moment. Suppose as well that this universe has an infinite number of people, and suppose that one night every single room in your glorious hotel is full, with one person in each room, and then the president shows up. The president of space. She's heard many stories about your marvelous hotel and wants to stay in it herself that night. You'd love to have the publicity. You don't want to turn her down, and yet every room is full. So the question is, what do you do? One relevant detail here is that your guests are very accommodating to a degree. They're so happy to stay in your hotel that they don't even mind if you wake them up in the middle of the night and tell them to switch to a different room, as long as you provide a new room and don't kick them out and they don't have to share rooms. So, for example, the person in room 1 is happy to surrender their room to the president of space, as long as you can find a new room for that displaced guest to stay in. In the next video, we'll look at one approach to resolving this problem and making room for the president, and then present the second part of the riddle. But see if you can come up with an answer yourself first, and let us know if you think of something you want to share.